Okay, there's this cowboy, he's working the, he's out mending the fences where he's a ranch hand. And, yeah, he's a tough cowboy, he's been working for years. And he's on his horse, and about the time a snake scares the horse, it bucks him off. He reaches before he hits the ground and catches his arm, just right about here, on the barbed wire fence, and it slices it clean off. And he gets up, walks over to his saddlebag, finds his sewing kit, picks up his arm, puts it on a post, butts up against it, sews that dude right back on, gets on his horse, rides back into the ranch. Well, the boss is standing there, and he sees him coming. He goes, "My God, what happened to you?" He explains it all. You know, and he said, "I sewed my arm right back on." And he said, "You have got to be the toughest cowboy I've ever seen in my life." He said, "I'm going to give you 3 weeks paid vacation." And he said, "You're the new straw boss." He goes, "All right." And the other one is the turtle that gets robbed by the band of snails.
Yeah, and what happened?
And the police come and they investigate. And they say, "Can you tell us what they look like?" He said, "No, it all happened so fast." The news is out all the time. Even seeing how running around, I know that I should be, but then I just can't do. Everybody knew the name.
home late and you come home early. Come home big when you're feeling small. Come home straight and you come home curly. Time you don't come home at all.
That's my cousin. Oh, glad my part. You know what, dude? You guys gave me the short mic. That's crippled as all get out, and there with crutches, and he walks up, and they help him on stage, and the guy said, "What's your name?" He said, "My name is Robert, I don't remember his last name, Robert something." And he said, "Robert, how long you been like this?" He said, "Ever since a bad car wreck when I was young." And he said, "Robert, do you believe?" He said, "I believe." He said, "Do you believe we can help you tonight with the help of God?" He said, "I believe." He said, "Does everybody believe we can help Robert?" Everybody goes, "Amen, hallelujah." And it was really exciting. And he says, "Robert, I want you to put your donation in the, you know, the, whatever the thing is." And he says, "Put it in there." Yeah, the donation plate. He said, "I want you to go behind those curtains." He said, "And we're going to try to help some more folks here." And he hollers out there, "Is there anybody else?" And there's a guy come up there, and he says, "What's your name?" He says, "My name's Carl." And he says, "Carl?" He says, "Do you need help tonight?" He said, "I need help." He said, "Do you believe we can help you?" And he goes, "Yeah, I believe." And he said, "Okay." He said, "Does everybody think we can help him?" And everybody, "Hallelujah, amen." I mean, it was crazy. And he said, "You saw Carl back there?" And he says, "I mean, we saw Robert back there." He said, "I want you to go back there with him." And he said, "And put your donation in." And he did. And he goes back there behind a curtain. In the meantime, he asked anybody else. Nobody else would get up there. And he said, "Robert, you back there?" He said, "I'm back here." He says, "Carl, you back here?" He goes, "Yes." And he said, "You boys believe we can help you tonight. With the power of God and my help and the Lord's help, do you believe we can heal you?" And they both said, and Robert said, "Yes." And he said, "Everybody believe?" And they all go, "We believe." He said, "Robert, I want you to walk like a normal man." He said, "Throw them crutches out over that curtain." And man, it was like, they come flying out of the stage. And he says, "Carl, you back here?" And he goes, "Yes." And he said, "I want you to speak to me." And he goes, "Robert fell down." "My dog don't bark, he don't bite no grass. My dog don't bark, he don't bite no grass. When the sun goes down, you ought to hear him howl.
About the Constitution. They are among the best. With those 3 square meals a day and a place to rest. You smell that fried chicken in that country hand. You got the first bottom business, mashed potatoes and candy yam. Well, you heard about the good Queen Mary sailing on the northern sea, but you ain't never took no boat ride till you was riding on the Wetherbee.
Thank you. Yeah, let that moon whistle.
I'll be alone, maybe I could die. Well, since my baby left me, found a new place to dwell. Down at the end of the lonely street, at the heartbreak hotel now. I get so lonely, baby. I get so lonely, baby. I get so lonely, I could die. Someone said something about someone's kid. It's all over and it's all done. Somebody done called 911. Your lady don't like my old lady. Your lady left it ain't pretend to be my old lady. Your lady don't like my old lady. Your lady don't like my old lady. Mother, mother, ocean, I've heard you call. I wanted to sail upon the water, and I was 3 feet tall. You seen it all. You seen it all. Watch the men that rowed you switch and sail the steam. In your belly you hold a treasure you have ever seen. Most of them dream. Most of them dream. Yes, I am a pirate. 200 years too late. The cannons don't thunder. There ain't nothing to plunder. I'm an old 40 little face. Arriving too late. Arriving too late. Let's try it. Share a grass. And I made enough money to buy my hand, but I pissed away so fast. Never meant to last. Never meant to last. Well, I haven't done that for over 2 weeks. I passed out in a rally in a front of you, but I gotta stop wishing. Gotta go fish, I'm down on rock bottom again. Just be free. Just be free. Younger women, I lived several wives. So I ran away, they're coming back one day. Still their man is a smile. You say why? You say why? Mother, mother, ocean, after all of the years I've spent. The occupational hazard is here. The occupation just ain't around. I feel like I have a friend. I feel like I have a friend. I feel like I have a friend. Here's the town.
Control the 1951.
Lord.